Hello everyone, today's topic for 12 physics chapter number 2 electric potential and capacitance is corona discharge. So today we will learn this phenomena of corona discharge. Okay, so let us begin.
Please subscribe our channel, like it, share and comment.
So what is corona discharge? So to understand this, let us take two conducting spheres A and B like this. So the radius of A is R1 and which is larger, and radius of B sphere is R2 which is smaller. So from this you can understand sphere A is larger, bigger sphere, and this is smaller than this. Now we will give some charge Q to the system. System means this charge Q is given to both of these two, and it will be distributed. Q1 will go on this and Q2 will go on smaller sphere. So this Q1 will reside on A and Q2 will remaining Q2 will go on B. Now can you calculate the potential difference, potential on sphere A? Our usual formula is there, charge upon 4 pi epsilon naught into radius. Okay. So this V1 will be Q1 charge on this sphere divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into R1. Now in the same way you can calculate charge on sphere B is Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught into R2. So this potential we can calculate. Now let us connect these two spheres to each other by connecting wire. Initially this sphere and this sphere are independent spheres. Though it is a system of cylinder, but there is no connection. Total charge given was Q, and that was distributed Q1 and Q2 on both the spheres, and we have calculated the individual potentials of these two spheres. Now what we will do, we will connect these two spheres by a connecting wire. This already conducting spheres, and we are connecting this by a conducting wire. Okay, it will conduct the charge. So it may be made up of metal. So like this we will connect. So now these two are connected. Now due to this, what will happen? There will be the flow of electron will happen, flow of charge will happen, and due to that what will happen? The potential of the both spheres becomes equal. Initially it was not equal, but now due to this connection, potential will become equal. So, and we have calculated these potentials, so we have to equate these two. So V1 is equal to V2 now in this case. So let us equate. So as the two spheres are connected by conducting wire, their potential must be same. So by equating these two, we are getting Q1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into R1 is equal to Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught into R2. Let us say equation 1, we will modify this equation by this relations. Q1 is equal to sigma 1 A1, Q2 is equal to sigma 2 A2. Usual formulas are there. And surface area of the sphere is 4 pi R square. So let us put these values in this equation and cancel which are common. So that modification, that simple calculation we can do, and we can write the equation. So I will directly write the equation, change in equation. So equation 1 becomes sigma 1 by sigma 2 is equal to R2 by R1. Sigma is what? Charge upon corresponding area. Here also, this is a surface charge density of this sphere, means charge upon surface area. Okay, so these are with usual notations. So this equation you will get by putting these values in this equation. Okay, and the sigma 1, sigma 2 are charge densities, surface charge densities of the two spheres. Now, here, the sphere with smaller radius has a larger charge density to maintain same potential. Okay, to maintain the same potential, whatever charge density is required, those are given here. Okay, so with this discussion, we will stop here for this conducting spheres. We will take another example. Okay. We will use the concept which we have learned here in the another example. Now look, what concept we have used? We have used from this what we have got, these surface densities. Look, from this you can say this smaller radius sphere has larger charge density. From equation number 2, what we can learn? The sphere with smaller radius has a larger charge density. Okay, this is very important. Less area, more charge density will be there. more area, less charge density will be there. Okay, so charge will get distributed on the more area, no? So density will decrease. So let us take another example. So let us take now in this case non-sphere shape like this. Okay, it is a 3D shape, but I have shown 2D like, but it is a 3D shape, but non-sphere shape, and some positive charge is distributed on the surface. Now if the charge is given to the conductor, the charge density will not be uniform on entire surface. So if it was a sphere, then it was uniformly distributed, no problem. But here irregular shape. So here flatten, here more curvature, here more curvature, here more curvature, flatten. So like this. So this charge will not be uniformly distributed. So portion where the surface is more or flat, surface is more or flat surface is there. The here we will have, or we can say it is having a large radius. Okay, it is a part of big circle, we can say. Straight line is what? Part of big circle. So here you have less density of the charge. Okay. So charge density at such portion will be smaller from equation number 2. So equation number 2, from equation number 2, what we have learned? The charge density will be more for less surface area. Here more surface area, so charge density will be less. Now a portion where the surface is more curved. So this portion, this portion, this portion. So the density will be larger. Or in other word, the charge density will be large where the radius of curvature is small. Here radius of curvature is more, so charge density is less. Here radius of curvature is less, but charge density will be more. Okay, so here more charge is there now, we can say, compared to this surface. So the electric field just outside the surface of the conductor is this. Just outside the conductor is what? Sigma upon epsilon naught. Okay, now thus the electric field near the portion of the smaller radius of curvature is large as compared to the field near the portion of large radius of the curvature. Sigma upon epsilon naught is there, epsilon naught will not change, it is everywhere, it is common. But sigma, at this place sigma is more, at this place sigma is less. That is why electrical field will be more at this place, means E2 is more than E1. E2 is more than E1. So if conductor has a pointed shape, means what? It is just like a pointed shape, we can say, like a needle. More, so instead of this, we can take needle. So that will have more again surface charge density, and electrical field developed will be again more. Okay, so electrical field will be high. Now the electrical field near this pointed ends will be very high, may cause dielectric breakdown in the air. So what will happen? This electrical field will go in the direction. Suppose here air molecules will be there, and they will attract. If this is a in this direction, it will attract the electrons from the air. It will attract the electrons from the air, and air get polarized. Okay, air get polarized. So, and this intensity is that much tremendous that these electrons are leaving the molecules of the air. Okay, and that is why this is called electric dielectric breakdown. Okay, so the charge may jump from the conductor to the air because of increase the conductivity of air. Now, as the charge got free, so that air becomes conducting, and again this charge will jump in that, because that is a conducting material now. So this phenomena is called this corona discharge. So often this discharge of air is accompanied by a visible glow surrounding the pointed end. So this charge from this air will be accumulated here, some glow will be formed, and this is called corona discharge. So this phenomena is called corona discharge. So I hope you understand this. Simply what? Suppose one pointed structure is there, here charge density will be more, less area, so charge density will be there. So more electrical field will be there. So this electrical field will be generated. So this electrical field, what this will do? Suppose this is an air molecule. Okay. So what it will do? It will polarize like this. Negative charge will go on this side, positive charge will go on this side. So this will happen to every point. And if this is again more, we can say, so this charge will come out, okay, and this is called air breakdown. So due to that, what will happen? To balance this, it will take charge from another air molecule like this. So it will, the breakdown of another molecule will be there. So like this, this will happen continuously, and this air becomes conducting by discharging the charge. Why this charge is discharged from this molecule? Due to this high electrical field. Why this is a high electrical field? Because less area, more charge is there, so high electrical field. Okay, so wherever there is a pointed surfaces are there, and if it is conducting and some charge is given to this, and if the charge is more than its capacity, then such a kind of phenomena will happen, and this phenomena is called coronal discharge. Okay, so I hope you like this, you understand everything. Let us stop here. Thank you.